Now the topic is web commerce business model, and that is the topic of web technology and e-commerce. This is subject, and the subject code is KMBIT02. Okay, so these are some references about this topic. Means you may refer your textbook, as well as these are some good blogs that you may refer for further study about the topic. Okay, so there are various web commerce business model, like B2C business model is there, B2B business model is there, consumer to consumer, C2C is there, peer to peer business model is there, M-commerce business model is there, and e-governance like G2C, G2B, G2G, and G2G, G2E is also there. Okay, so these are some various e-commerce business model that are existed. Okay, so first we will discuss about business to consumer. So what is business to consumer basically? You may see that here is a business organization, and that means one, this is customer and website. Okay, so customer orders through the website. Okay, and website will means make order through the this business organization, means order processing part, and business organization supplies this means the order, the product that ordered by customer to the customer, means it supplies order to the customer basically. Okay, so this is B2C e-commerce. Okay, so B2C business to consumer e-commerce, or commerce between companies and consumers, involve customers gathering information, okay, purchasing physical goods and receiving products over an electronic network. Like if you see the example of this B2C e-commerce, so what is that? Like Dell selling me a laptop. If I want to purchase a laptop, then I would go to the Dell website, and after that I'll order by assembling it, means by choosing or by picking the options over there, and after that I will order this laptop from Dell website, okay, by paying the amount they have asked. Okay, so the term business to consumer refers to the process of selling products and services directly between consumers who are the end users of its product or service. Most companies that sell directly to consumers can be referred to as B2C company. Nowadays, if you see the market share of B2C type of e-commerce is growing continuously, just because every company wants to tap their consumers. Okay, so B2C became immensely popular during the dot-com boom of late 1990s, when it was mainly used to refer the online retailers who sold product and services to the consumers through the internet. Okay, so if you see that when it came into existence, so it was around late 1990. Okay, and business to consumer is among the most popular and widely known sales model. The idea of B2C was first utilized by Michael Eldridge in 1979, who used television as the primary medium to reach out to the consumers. Means in 1979, if you know that the primary medium of this means tapping the customer is the television, and but in today's scenario, if you see that internet is the medium to reach out to the customer. Okay, so B2C traditionally referred to the mall shopping, eating out at restaurant, pay-per-view movies, and infomercials. Okay, infomercials means that advertisement that provide information. Okay, so however, the rise of internet created a whole new B2C business channels in the form of e-commerce, or selling of goods and services over the internet. Okay, so although many B2C companies fell victim to the subsequent dot-com bust as investor interest in the sector dwindled and venture capital funding dried up. Okay, so B2C leaders such as Amazon and Priceline survived and stake out and have since seen great success. If you see about that dot-com bubble burst, okay, so at that time a few company have survived, and Amazon and Priceline were the leader in this field. Okay, So as just because of this B2C selling, B2C type of selling, okay, so any business that relies on B2C sales must maintain good relations with their customers to ensure their return. Okay, unlike business to business, whose marketing campaigns are geared to demonstrate the value of product or service, companies that rely on B2C must elicit an emotional response to their marketing in their consumers. Okay, means in their customers, means basically it is saying here that if you study the marketing practices of B2B versus B2C, you will see notable difference in between these two marketing practices. Basically means you need to focus towards the emotions of consumer, means you need to tap the emotions of your consumers while dealing with the B2C, okay, and while dealing with B2B, you just put towards the quality as well as quantity part. Means you need generally you need to focus on that quantity discount part much more over there. Okay, so this is the basic difference of B2B and B2C. Okay, and now if you talk about this B2B model, so what is B2B? E-commerce business organization is there, wholesaler is there, customer is there, and website is there. So basically customer will buy a product from wholesaler, then wholesaler will order through the website of business organization. Okay, after entering their order on website of business organization, okay, then business organization will process the order of that wholesaler and supplies the item or product or service to wholesaler, and after that wholesaler will sell this product to customer. Like most of the car manufacturing companies works on this model. Okay, like Maruti provides its vehicle through dealers. Okay, so they send their product to dealer, and after that dealer sells the product to the customer basically. Okay, so that is B2B e-commerce. Okay, so B2B e-commerce is simply defined as e-commerce between companies, and about 70% of e-commerce is of this type. Okay, if you see that the market share of B2B type of e-commerce, it is around 70%, like Intel selling microprocessor to Dell, means the selling is in between company to company basically. Okay, so business to business, B2B refers to the commerce between two business rather than the commerce between a business and an individual consumer. Okay, and transactions at wholesale level are usually business to business, while those at the retail level are most often business to consumer. Okay, if you see, the dollar value of business to business transaction is significantly higher than the B2C activity, because business are more likely to purchase higher priced goods and services and purchase more of them than consumers are. Okay, that's why few of the people refers to B2B rather than B2C. Okay, a bicycle manufacturer, you may take here the example of like nowadays we are implementing AI in agriculture sector. So if you see, companies are selling their AI enabled services to companies, okay, not to the individual consumers. Okay, basically they are poor farmers and they don't have enough money to purchase such type of app from these companies. So they have shifted their interest from B2C to B2B. Okay, a bicycle manufacturer, for example, will purchase a truckload of bicycle tire. Okay, so this is the example of B2B type of business. Now, B2B does not exclude B2C. Business to business, you are operating in business to business, that means you can't operate in B2C environment. That is not true. Okay, so a company selling to businesses can also sell directly to the consumers. Okay, a telephone manufacturer can sell in bulk to companies or one at a time to consumers shopping online or at office supply store like Vodafone, Airtel, and Idea and other telecom companies are offering corporate plans also as well as individual plans also. Okay, for common people means B2C, they are offering B2C services also and they are offering B2B services also. So a firm that provides health and wellness consulting to corporations can also advise individuals one on one or in group presentations. Okay, so this is all about the B2B type of e-commerce. Now next is the consumer to consumer. What is consumer to consumer? So if you see the entity, so there is a website and customer one is there, customer two is there, and customer one wants to sell product and customer two wants to buy product. So customer one will place will put their ad on this website, means basically OLX and Quikr are best example of this C2C. Okay, so it places website places the advertisement. Okay, and customer two will receive customer one will receive money from customer two and customer two will receive products from customer one. Okay, so this type of transactions comes under the category of C2C e-commerce. Okay, means consumer to consumer e-commerce. So consumer to consumer e-commerce or C2C is simply commerce between private individual or consumers. Like example is OLX and Quikr. C2C is the common acronym used to describe a relatively new business model known as consumer to consumer. Other prominent industry model include B2C, B2B. Okay, so means C2C is nowadays we are dealing with, like in case of car, okay, Cars 24 is there, Cars Deal is there, and many more companies are there. Means they are working on used car, okay, used property, used furniture and other products, consumer durables are there, electronic items are also there. Okay, so most of few of companies are there that are dealing only with C2C. Okay, so the C2C market has evolved since the late 1990s in large part because of internet and e-commerce. And in the C2C market, one consumer buys goods from another consumer using a third party business to facilitate the transaction. Consumer to consumer market provides an innovative way to allow customers to interact with each other. Okay, so traditional market requires means they can, customer can interact with the another customer, like you may chat over there or you may make a call over there. Okay, so traditional market require business to customer relations in which a customer goes to business in order to purchase a product or service. So in customer to customer market, the business facilitate an environment where customer can sell goods or service to each other. So it is basically creating an environment where one consumer can sell the intended product or service to the other customer by using this web portal or e-commerce portal. Okay, so this is C2C type of e-commerce. Next is peer-to-peer business model. What is this? The peer-to-peer business model has been around for some time. Okay, you may take C2C as the example of peer-to-peer business model. Okay, so the largest peer-to-peer business model known in e-commerce is eBay. And eBay is an e-marketplace where both businesses and individual can sell goods to each other. Means individual can sell to business, or individual can sell to individual, or business can sell to individual, or business can sell to business. So that is known as the peer-to-peer business model. Means anyone can sell to the business or individual. Means both type of transaction is there. Okay, so peer-to-peer business model depend mostly on attracting both the customers and vendors or sellers. Okay, and peer-to-peer business model in e-commerce is not a new thing. The person-to-person model is even in the modern transaction method of e-commerce. Okay, so e-commerce depends a lot of transactions that are completed from person-to-person rather than business to business. Okay, so that's why it is known as person to person, because any individual can sell to business as well as individual, or any business can sell to business as well as individual. Okay, so mostly bidding is there, like eBay. If you want to put any product over there, eBay, and you may quote the minimum price, hai na? And after that, anyone who will put the highest bidding over there, that will get the product. Okay, so this type of model is known as the peer-to-peer business model. See here. Okay, means like first process is list your item on eBay. First you have listed, means you are reseller, means you are having product. Okay, so first process is means you will list your product on eBay, and highest bidder means buyer. Okay, that will win, means highest bidder will win. Okay, and then the third process means buyer pays for the item directly to you plus shipping and handling fee, and then reseller will select our drop shipper. Okay, sometimes it may be provided by eBay, or it may chosen by this reseller. So reseller pay the wholesaler fee price to the drop shipper, and drop shipper ships the item to your buyer with the resellers, means your name, company name, and address. Okay, so this is the peer-to-peer business model. Okay, next is next type of business model is m-commerce business model. What is m-commerce business model? M-commerce means selling and purchasing products, or online providing the services. Okay, so in order for companies and organizations that to be successful in m-commerce, they need more evaluate innovative new strategies. Basically, what is m-commerce means doing all transactions through mobile or cellular device. Okay, so they require new business model to deliver better services to customers. According to the m-commerce companies, focus of logical architecture for products, customer can buy products and get information about these products. Okay, so most of the e-commerce site like Amazon have limited success in e-commerce, but however, one thing they all have common in that m-commerce is the important way to enhance their brands, increase their sale and product, and provide better services. What are the basic reasons behind this success of m-commerce? So if you see here that most of the people are easy to use in this cellular device rather than using this laptop or personal computer. So in short, the key feature of m-commerce is brighter than e-commerce, because subscribers are much more higher in terms of if you talk about the cell phone subscribers. So they are in large number in comparison to that e-commerce subscriber. Okay, so basically that is the key success factor of this m-commerce business model. Now the next type of business model is e-governance. So electronic governance or e-governance is the application of information and communication technology for delivering government services, exchange of information, communication transactions, integration of various standalone systems and services between government to citizen, government to business, government to government, government to employee, as well as the back office processes and interaction within the entire government framework. If you talk about the e-governance nowadays, most of if you talk about India, okay, every state has its own website, state governance, and even local governance is also having its own website. Okay, so that is what basically dealing with the e-governance. Okay, so e-governance, there are certain types of e-governance, like G2C is here, G2B is here, G2G is here, and G2E is here. Okay, so through e-governance, government services are made available to citizens in a convenient, efficient, and transparent manner. The three main target groups that can be distinguished in governance concepts and governments are government, citizens, and business interest groups. Okay, means if you talk about the three main target group of e-governance, so they are government itself, citizens, and business or interest groups, business groups. Okay, So in e-governance, there are no distinct boundaries. Means anyone can interact with any other person. Means consumer can interact like G2C. G2B is there, G2G is there. So means dealing all the governing related process through this use of ICT comes under this category e-governance. Okay. So if you talk about the various interactions of e-governance, so like here is G2G means government to government. Okay, means when the exchange of information and services is within the periphery of government is termed as G2G interaction. Okay, and this can be both horizontal, and horizontal means among various government entities. Okay, and vertical means between national, state and local government entities. Means vertical, if a national government wants to deal with the state government, or a state government wants to interact with local government, they can interact. Okay, so that is vertical type of G2G e-governance process. Okay, and if you talk about the horizontal, means Indian government may talk to that USA, UK government. Okay, so that type of transaction comes under this category G2G. Okay, next is G2C. What is G2C? Government to citizen, the interaction between the government and general public is G2C interaction. Here an interface is set up between government and citizens, okay, which enables citizens to get access to a wide variety of public services. The citizen had the freedom to share their views and grievances on government policies anytime, anywhere. Like if you see most of the politicians are using nowadays Twitter. Okay, and if you make a tweet regarding any services to the ministry, concerned ministry, okay, they will immediately react over it. Okay, so that is what the implementation of G2C means. Anyone, the citizen, or has the freedom to share their views and grievances directly to the government policies anytime, anywhere. So this is possible just because of implementing this G2C, government to citizen. Okay, next is G2B. What is G2B? Means in this case, the e-governance helps the business class to interact with the government seamlessly. It aims at eliminating red tapism, saving time, cost and establishing transparency in the business environment while interacting with government. Okay, nowadays if you see the rating of ease of doing business, that has been improved from 134th position to 60 67th position, I think. Okay, so that is just because of implementing this e-governance in the field G2B, means government to business, means most of the transactions are now online. Okay, and there are least formalities over there. Means if you talk about that offline mode of formalities, they take much more time, okay, cost, as well as there is no transparency over there. Okay, so after implementing ICT in this sector, okay, you may save the time, cost, as well as transparencies also there. Okay, so that is the G2P type of e-governance structure. Now the last structure is G2E. So what is G2E? Government to employee. The government of any country is the biggest employer, and so it also deals with employees on a regular basis, and as other employers do. So ICT helps in making the interaction between government and employees fast and efficient, along with raising their level of satisfaction by providing prerequisite and add-on benefit. Okay, means if you talk about any direct benefit transfer, you may directly transfer benefits to the account of your employee. You may share any notice on real-time basis, any subsidy over real-time basis, any advisory, any instructions you may put on real-time basis by applying this G2E type of e-governance. Okay, so this is all about the various e-commerce business models that are web commerce business model that are existed. If you want to study further, so you may refer your textbook, as well as these are some good blogs in this regard. Okay, so you may refer it. Thank you. If you have any query or doubt, you may ask.
Oh, yeah.